Boston Dynamics and Spot the Robot Dog are on a charm offensive, trying to dance their way into our hearts. Is Spot here to help us or steal our jobs and those of our canine companions? Or even worse, is Spot going to end up being one of our robot overlords? If you want to know more about Spot, you've come to the right place. We're going to do a background check, look at costs and capabilities, see where it's being used, and try and find out if we're just living in a Black Mirror episode. In 2004, with the help of NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory and Harvard University, and funded by DARPA, the research wing of the U.S. Department of Defense, Bigdog was the first quadruped robot created by Boston Dynamics. DARPA was looking for a robot pack mule to help infantry soldiers by carrying their gear over terrain too rough or steep for wheeled or tracked vehicles. The lead researcher was Martin Bueller, who had just finished a 12-year tenure at McGill University, bringing with him an unfinished Rex robot to Boston Dynamics. Bigdog was 3 feet long, 2.5 feet tall, weighed 240 pounds, and could carry as much as 340 pounds of extra weight. It could walk across various types of difficult terrain, and as fast as 6 miles an hour, and up a 35-degree incline. It had a computer to control locomotion, process sensors, and handle communications with the user. It had a gyroscope for balance and could see with a stereo vision system and LiDAR for light detection and ranging, which is a 3D laser scanner. External sensors include joint position, joint force, and ground contact, while internal sensors monitored hydraulic pressure, oil temperature, and general motor functions. Bigdog was powered with a go-kart engine, and it sounded like someone was using a chainsaw, really loud. By 2011, Boston Dynamics demonstrated the Wildcat robot that was the fastest quadruped robot at the time, but provided zero improvements to noise. It was only a year later in 2012 that Boston Dynamics unveiled the Legged Squad Support System, or LS3, also known as the Alpha Dog. This system was a major upgrade. It was huge, about the size of a horse, was faster, and could carry as much as 400 pounds. Most importantly, it was quieter, making about 1/10 the amount of noise. It also had an awesome new feature that allowed it to listen to and obey voice commands. Among other commands, it could be told to turn on and off, or be told to follow the user from a close distance or from far away. It would even be given a manipulator arm that could, rather impressively, pick up and throw a cinder block. In spite of all its upgrades, in 2015, the Marines kicked Alpha Dog out of the Corps, complaining it made too much noise. Okay, fat history lesson done, we can now focus on Spot of today. This is where things get really interesting. If you happen to be interested in purchasing Spot, and if you're an academic or work at a research institute, Boston Dynamics will give you a discount. Otherwise, you're going to have to shell out 75 grand for the base model called Explorer. The Enterprise version will set you back around 100 grand, but it comes with the Spot dock, so it can recharge its own batteries. Spot's base model includes two cameras on the front, two in the back, and one on each side, but if you have the money, Spot can be upgraded with some pretty amazing tech. They're called payloads. The most famous upgrade is the manipulator arm, allowing it to open doors, pull levers, and turn valves, along with domestic duties like picking up laundry and putting the dishes in the dishwasher. Unlike Alpha Dog, who's capable of throwing cinder blocks like a medieval rock-throwing champion, Spot can't throw them, but it does a good job of dragging them around. The Spot Cam payload is a coloring camera with a 360-degree field of view thanks to 5 Sony cameras, providing the operator with complete situational awareness. There are high-sensitivity microphones and amplified speakers integrated into the Spot Cam, allowing remote auditory inspections and two-way communications between the user and anyone close to Spot. If you need a more powerful camera to allow for proper inspection, you're probably going to want the Spot Cam Plus payload, which has the exact same features as the regular version, but it also includes the pan-tilt zoom camera, which has a 30x optical zoom, allowing for detailed inspection from a distance. If you need to capture thermal imaging, Boston Dynamics has you covered with the Spot Cam Plus IR, which also has the exact same features as the previous model, but it includes a FLIR thermal camera on top. The audio input is also upgraded thanks to a Sennheiser shotgun microphone. If you need super precise measurements and improved map making, the LiDAR payload is indispensable. Called the Spot EAP for Enhanced Autonomy Package, this payload improves Spot's autonomy by allowing it to create larger and more accurate maps. Spot's base 3D cameras have an effective range of only 4 meters for autonomous mapping, but with the LiDAR payload, that range increases to 100 meters. There's a CPU payload called Spot Core. It's an additional processor for developers to run their own software locally on Spot. Unlike the computers inside Spot, the CPU payload is open to development. If a CPU isn't going to cut it, maybe you want to integrate AI and machine learning into Spot. In that case, you're going to want the Spot Core AI, a GPU payload for running computationally intensive tasks. The system is environmentally hardened and has higher protection standards than even Spot itself, so operating it in the winter or in the rain isn't a problem. Now that we know more or less what Spot is capable of, let's look at how industry is using it. What kind of jobs is Spot performing? Spot became commercially available in 2019, but was only available through the early adopter program. Its main purpose was to test Spot's capabilities, so they were very selective in who would get access. The test program saw Spot being used for a variety of different tasks, including being used to document construction progress, monitor remote or hazardous environments, and provide situational awareness. Environments included power generation facilities, factory floors, research facilities, construction sites, inside mines, on offshore oil rigs, and even decommissioned nuclear sites. On the construction site, Spot was hired by the company Pomerlo to capture images of construction progress. Equipped with both the Spot Cam and LiDAR payloads, Spot captured around 5,000 images per week on their 500,000 square foot project, always capturing the images from the exact same location, allowing for precise monitoring of progress. Using third-party Hollow Builder software, which makes use of 360-degree imagery data, computer vision, and artificial intelligence, Spot freed up around 20 hours of work per week, allowing engineers to focus on analyzing data rather than spending time taking pictures. At the power generation facilities, Spot worked at both Woodside, an Australian natural gas producer, and at National Grid in the US, who used it at a high-voltage DC converter station. Robots weren't new to the Woodside team. They'd already tested wheeled robots to perform inspection around the sprawling onshore plant, but they found that it had difficulty operating on uneven terrain and moved too slowly to be effective across large distances, and of course, it couldn't get upstairs. Woodside determined that Spot could be used for gauge reading, leak detection, noise anomaly detection, thermal inspection, gas detection, and remote inspection. In the future, they hope to use Spot to verify if valves or electrical equipment are isolated in an emergency, saving humans from having to do that dangerous work. Spot's work at Woodside was also valuable for Boston Dynamics. When the robot first showed up on site, it was unable to walk up mesh metal stairs, but that limitation only lasted a few weeks when Boston Dynamics did a software update. At National Grid's Sandy Pond Converter Station, their primary goal was to have Spot provide site inspection and monitor equipment condition. National Grid equipped Spot with the Cam Plus IR to allow for thermal inspection and to take advantage of the 30x pan-tilt zoom camera, as well as a LiDAR payload to make sure Spot knew exactly where it was. With Spot able to handle the strong electrical fields, perform its duties with precise repeatability, and getting human operators out of harm's way, National Grid hopes to use the robot at other facilities as well in the future. On the offshore oil rig, BP acquired a Spot with the hopes of removing employees from potentially hazardous situations and environments. Not only are oil rigs inherently dangerous places, where exposure to high and low temperatures are the norm, but simply transporting employees back and forth is also dangerous. By having Spot undertake day-to-day tasks like recording observations, scanning for abnormalities, tracking corrosion, and checking gauges, it allows specialist employees to spend their time performing more complex and high-impact activities. BP found that Spot provided a number of benefits. Not only did it improve safety, but it also improved operational efficiency by gathering larger datasets thanks to being able to operate many different types of sensors simultaneously. They also found that Spot helped them reduce their carbon footprint, not only by having sensors that can detect methane leaks, but also having Spot do jobs humans would otherwise normally have done, requiring fewer trips to oil platforms, reducing emissions from transportation. Spot gets around. It's been tested to work in underground mines, was hired by Ford to create digital maps of its factories and enter areas too dangerous for humans, SpaceX hired one to perform site inspection, including after rockets have exploded on landing, and one was even used at Chernobyl to measure radiation. Spot might even get a job on Mars. NASA's JPL has been testing Spot to have it inspect and map out lava tubes. Sometimes Spot gets the easy jobs, like in New Zealand where it was used to herd sheep, as well as in Singapore, where Spot was used to ensure people were obeying social distancing rules. In fact, thanks to the pandemic, it's Dr. Spot now. Dr. Spot was introduced to 40 patients at a women's hospital in Boston, where doctors and nurses could interact with patients with an iPad attached to Spot. For the moment, the Dr. Spot payload includes sophisticated cameras and computer vision to identify a person's face even when they're wearing a mask. It can also assess body temperature, breathing and pulse rates, and uses special lens filters to determine blood oxygen saturation. So far, Spot has been a pretty good dog, making companies more efficient, freeing people up to do more value-added tasks, getting employees out of harm's way while being able to run a gamut of sensors, and thanks to AI, Spot can, or will be able to, do it all on its own. But what about when Spot isn't such a good doggo? Let's not forget, DARPA spent at least $42 million on Spot's predecessors. Surely there's something in between playful, helpful Spot and the killer robot dogs from Black Mirror. Well, let me introduce to you, at the very top of the slope, NYPD's DigiDog. Still very tame, DigiDog is Spot colored blue and has been used at least three times. The first time took place in October of 2020 when a suspected gunman barricaded himself in a home. It was also used in December of the same year when two armed gunmen held five people hostage in a Queens home. And the third time being in February of 2021 when police responded to a home invasion. According to police, it was used to contact hostages and have it transport food. So far, not anything that risks having Spot break the first of three laws of robotics. A robot may not injure a human being or, through inaction, allow a human being to come to harm. Sadly, this first rule of robotics, created by Isaac Asimov, has no bearing on real life, and such notions are probably considered naive by important people in high places. But rest assured, ignoring Asimov's sage advice could lead to some pretty dark places. What might that look like? Well, let's go back to when the Marines were first testing out the smaller sized Spot. Here, they used it in a room clearing exercise, sending the robot in ahead of soldiers. But how long before it's decided it's safer to have Spot do the shooting? It wouldn't be very hard. Just create some new payloads. You could have a sentry gun, grenade launcher. Heck, you could even have high explosive suicide Spot, or even a demolition charge that places itself autonomously. Spot isn't the only robot dog in town. Ghost Robotics has their own version, currently working with the Australian Army, apparently not yet armed. In what could be a sign of hope, the only authorized projectile-type payload is Ghost Robotics' bomb disposal cannon, seen here taking out a bucket. Easy customization is a key feature of robotics. Spot can be programmed to carry anything you want. To make this very point, a group called Mischief attached a paintball gun to Spot, giving viewers a chance to control it remotely, allowing users to rampage in a museum-like setting. Boston Dynamics was none too pleased, apparently offering two free units if they took the paintball gun off. They also released a statement through Twitter condemning the portrayal of their technology in a way that promotes violence, harm, or intimidation. They pointed to their mission statement, which is to create robots that inspire, delight, and positively impact society, as well as their terms and conditions of sale, which states that Spot must be used legally and cannot be used to harm or intimidate animals or people. They go on to say that violations will automatically void the warranty and prevent the robot from being updated, serviced, repaired, or replaced. They don't mention whether or not they'd be able to deactivate Spot in an emergency, something that might look quite similar to this. Although in this case, that's not what happened. This is just Spot slipping on the paint-splattered floor. So you know what that means? This is one of its weaknesses. And if you don't believe me, here's more proof. So let's just do a quick comparison between science fiction and reality. In Black Mirror, the robot was really agile and fast. Spot isn't anywhere near there, but give it time. Boston Dynamics has a robot that can get on top of buildings, Atlas is already doing backflips, and Ghost Robotics has shown some really impressive development in quadruped motion. The robot dog from Black Mirror was able to hack its way and gain access to anywhere it wanted to be. Spot so far is only able to open doors and let itself in. Still pretty creepy. The robot also had a gun on its arm and was able to release an explosive charge. While the gun wouldn't be on Spot's arm, this combination is entirely possible today. In fact, here's Ghost Robotics dog leaving behind some kind of package. What Spot and other quadruped robots evolve into remains to be seen. The only thing that's certain though is progress will be made.